Hey, what is up, guys? This is Rich here with Gaming Tech United, and as is customary, as soon as E3 is approaching, we have another rumor. So I figured I would go over this with you guys because it seems to be the latest Nintendo rumor, and it is the E3 showroom instruction packet that has leaked via Reddit. Now, I'm not 100% sure that it is real, but we'll go over that in a second. As you can see, the top says Nintendo, of course, says the E3 showroom instruction packet, internal use only. Now, we're just gonna jump right into it and see if I like, and if you guys like, what this has to say. So we have the Nintendo 3DS, I'll zoom in it for you. We have Dragon Quest, Warriors of Eden, Fossil Fighters, Infinite Gear. I've never heard of Fossil Fighters before, so I would like to hear what that's about. Pokemon, the new ones, Professor Layton vs. Phoenix Wright, which is a game that a lot of people are excited about. Not so much me, but hey, everyone has their own cup of tea. Project Steam, which I haven't heard about. Star Fox 3DS, which is a temporary title, which seems pretty cool. I know we did get that remake of Star Fox when the 3DS, I want to say when it first came out. And then, of course, it ends with Super Smash Bros. 3DS. Now, this is a decent list. I wanted to get into the Dragon Quest series last iteration, but I just didn't have the money to. So if this game does come to us, I would love to jump into it. Like I said, Fossil Fighters, I mean, I'd like to hear about it. Pokemon, I'm a huge Pokemon fan, so for sure. The Professor Layton vs. Phoenix Wright game I think could be cool. Project Steam, like I said, no idea what it is. Star Fox, a lot of people have been wanting it. Some have been wanting it on the Wii U though, so I guess that could be a disappointment for a lot of people. And of course, you know, Smash Bros. Is Smash Bros. So let's move on to the Wii U. This is what all the rumors have been swirling about. Everyone wants to know what flagship titles Nintendo is going to bring to E3, and this is what this list says. Of course, we have a little bit from Bayonetta 2. This is the Wii U exclusive. Hyrule Warriors, The Legend of Zelda Unbound King, which is a pretty cool title. Mario Party 10, Nintendo U, which is a temporary title. Pokken Fighter Tournament, Pushmo World, Shin Megami Tensei Cross Fire Emblem, Smash Brothers for Wii U. Then we move on to a Wii U HD collection, which brings Super Mario Sunshine and Wave Race Blue Storm, both in HD form. Then we have Xenomech Saga and Yarn Yoshi. So, Bayonetta, I played the last one. I wasn't a huge fan of it, but I figured if it's coming exclusively to the Wii U, I will for sure pick it up, at least rent it. Hyrule Warriors, I am a huge fan of the Warriors series, so I will be jumping on the game. I'll probably even pre-order that game. Legend of Zelda is a game that I am pretty excited for. I'll say I think they have to show us some gameplay here because that's what a lot of people are waiting for when it comes in terms of a new Nintendo console, and I think if this game really delivers visually and just interesting wise, I think a lot of people will go and pre-order or buy Wii U's. Next up we have Mario Party 10, really not my cup of tea. Nintendo U, which I have zero idea what it is, but I think it could be pretty cool. I don't know what it is, like I said though. Pokken Fighter Tournament, that Pokemon fighting game, really seems like it's going to be a cool game, just from what we've heard about it. Very, very little, but a Pokemon fighting game just sounds badass. Pushmo World, which from what I've heard, is a puzzle type of game. Again, not something that I'm really into, but there is a lot of people who like that, so that's awesome for those people. Next up we have Shin Megami Tensei Cross Fire Emblem, which sounds really, really badass. That could be cool. Then, of course, you have the Super Smash Bros. For Wii U. That's going to be a monstrous game. I hope that they talk more about the GameCube controller and adapter. Maybe we could get some sort of, bundle where maybe for, I don't know, let's say 80, 90 US dollars, you can pick up the game and adapter and the controller all in one thing, which would be awesome. Then we move on to the very interesting Wii U HD collection with Super Mario Sunshine. Now this is a game that I did not get to play. I played it a little bit at a friend's house when it came out, but I never got to play through all of it, and I've heard a lot of people talk shit about it, so I'll probably end up trying to pick this up just to see what all the hype is about. And then next up is Wave Race Blue Storm. I mean, I'm not a huge racing fan other than the Mario Kart series, so I'll probably pass on that one, but I'm sure there's people who want to see it. Now, Xenomech Saga looks like it is that previously announced title X, and from what I've seen from that, that looks badass. It's definitely one of those games that I'm going to have to try out for sure. I'll probably pre-order it if this trailer comes to fruition and it's cool. Next up is Yarn Yoshi. Good looking game, visual wise, but I'm not a big Yoshi fan, and the Yarn series has just been kind of meh for me. At the bottom, we're going to look here, and there's a star. It says, Super Smash Bros. For Wii U 3DS and Nintendo U demos will include a set of NFP figures of Mario, Link, Samus, and Pikachu. So that's really cool. We're gonna finally see the NFP and NFC characters, which is just awesome because I'm really, really, really interested in seeing where Nintendo could go with this. Now, a lot of people are gonna say, is this real? Is this fake? What's going on? Honestly, I would like to see this. I mean, this seems like a pretty okay lineup. I would have liked to see maybe a Metroid game for the Wii U. Maybe I would have liked to see more flagship titles for the Wii U, but at the end of the day, it's all right. I don't know that I believe this is real, though, because it's just so blatant in your face. Now, this does seem to be part of a packet of information, but I don't know that Nintendo would just list everything on one sheet of paper. And I also don't know that it just seems so like movie oriented, you know, like this is the Nintendo E3 showroom, internal use only, bold underscore. So I don't know that that's very convincing for me, but like I said, what I've seen, I don't know if I could say, oh, Nintendo's gonna kill it with this lineup, but like I said, we're gonna have to see the NFP characters and how that works out. Pokken Fighters, the Legend of Zelda games are going to be big, not to mention the Shin Megami Tensei Cross Fire Emblem, and the HD collections for the Wii U, and then there's Hyrule Warriors and Bayonetta 2 also. I mean, there's a good amount of titles coming out. I hope that a lot of them come out 2014. It would really help the Wii U's image right now just to come out and have more titles hitting store shelves in 2014. The 3DS, you know, it looks okay. Like I said, a couple of the games I don't know. And I also really want to know what Nintendo U is for the Wii U. So all in all, this seems like an interesting leak. Like I said, not 100% sure that it's real, but I want to hear what your guys' thoughts are on it. Do you like what you see? Do you like what I talked about? Do you think that there's anything that you would like to see that's not on the list? We want to hear your guys' thoughts. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe, guys. Hit that thumbs up button. It really helps us. Like I said, hit the comments. And again, this is Rich with Gaming Tech United. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.